It's the state's top lawyer. It's Attorney General Lori Swanson's job to enforce the law in Minnesota. But tonight, some are calling on Swanson to step down for doing nothing about a problem that we exposed nearly 3 months ago. And this is one that could be costing all of us. So Nick Winkler's here now. And Nick, these critics are being very harsh. They think the Attorney General's just not doing her job.
Exactly. And 2.5 months ago, I sat right here and reported what the Attorney General's office told us, that Swanson lacks the authority to enforce a law more than a dozen county sheriffs are accused of breaking. Tonight, we've compiled 100 years of case law that says Swanson does have the authority, but is choosing not to use it. Attorney General Lori Swanson. It's her job to stop lawbreakers in Minnesota, but she's done nothing to stop this.
You've been breaking the law 10 years?
That's what the state auditor would like people to believe.
Wabasha County Sheriff Rodney Barch and at least 13 other county sheriffs are running what state auditor Rebecca Otto calls illegal safe driving programs. What are they? Well, if you're caught speeding or committing a minor traffic offense, you can take a class and avoid paying a more expensive ticket. Problem is, the counties, which say the programs are legal and that the law is unclear, pocket all of the money from the classes rather than giving the state a cut like they would when someone pays a ticket.
You gonna shut down the program?
No, not anytime soon.
That's illegal, according to Otto, and also an attorney general opinion from 2003. So, why won't Swanson go after these sheriffs? Well, Swanson told us she lacks the authority, but the Supreme Court disagrees. In this analysis, completed by attorney Mark Anfinson, who consults for KSTP, Anfinson says the court has consistently found the AG's authority to be broad. He also says there's little doubt that if the attorney general wanted to crack down on the county diversion programs, she has ample legal authority by which to do so. But since Swanson is not,
I will not be a part of illegal behavior.
Deb Russian, a county commissioner in Wabasha, is suing to stop her own sheriff's safe driving program. At a hearing recently, her attorney, Eric Cardall, says the AG's office admitted it does have the authority to step in.
If she's not willing to fulfill the duties of her office, she might want to just step down and let somebody else do it.
State Representative Steve Drazkowski is the top Republican on the House Judiciary Committee and represents parts of two counties running safe driving programs. Drazkowski says if the sheriffs are breaking the law, Swanson is ignoring embezzlement.
Well, it's just very unfortunate that we have a constitutional officer that is refusing to enforce real consequences for constitutional crimes.
Now, we've called, emailed, and stopped by the Attorney General's office. We've even provided her office a copy of our legal analysis, but Swanson has ignored our request to discuss the matter. Late today, though, her office did provide a two-sentence statement that answers none of our questions, but reads, "This matter is now pending in court. Briefing has been completed, and we expect the court to issue a ruling soon." This is clearly something, Leah, that the Attorney General does not want to talk about.
Nick, is it possible that she was at all swayed by the sheriffs who probably wanted her to keep her distance?
Most of these sheriffs are in rural areas. The answer right now is no. I actually checked with the Minnesota Sheriffs Association. They say absolutely not. They have not lobbied the AG on this matter.
All right, I'm sure we're going to hear more about this, Nick.
We will.
Thank you. Bill?